Alright guys, quick update. One, I just washed my car. It's been a while, so I'm just waxing off the little black specks that didn't come off. Little black marks there, perfect. So the Subaru deal, yeah. It's the BCM, or BCI, or BIE. Probably Body Integrated Electronics, something or other. For sure, I found a lot of posts about it. There's a little thing right there. I found a lot of posts about it. Even found a guy that replaced the little chip on the BCM himself, but of course he is a experienced guy with Nokia. You may have seen the post. It's on the Forester forum, and one guy probably out of Germany replaced it himself with some fine soldering, but I mean that's way beyond my skill level, to be honest. So I am kind of bummed, you know, that you just install some LEDs and one piece. It isn't like the car's wrecked, nothing else is wrong with it, it's just the map light timer. But it's just a bummer that you can't even install some LEDs without that happening. So I removed all the LEDs from the Forester, all 100%, entire car, exterior also, I meant all. And you know, the wife may go in, we really don't even have time, but we may just go in and see about a replacement or something. But I was tempted even to take out the WRX ones, but then again, the WRX is fine. The map lights all work perfectly, and I guess I shouldn't mess with what's working. And with my luck, I might even make it worse if I messed with it and break it. So I just want to pass on that BCM issue. You know, I read about it a long time ago. I just scoffed it off. I laughed at it. It is real. I mean, I can't believe it, but it's real. So everybody does have to keep in mind that that could happen when you're messing with all these LEDs on the Forester, on any car. I've also seen posts about the WRX for this issue. So it does kind of suck. A BCM unit is, I think I saw online, like 350, maybe 300, but the problem is it has to be programmed too. And that could be like a $600-$700 job at the dealer. So I don't really know anybody that's not going to at least try to see if they can, you know, get a warranty. If someone does, they probably wouldn't mess with those bulbs again. That would kind of be your lesson learned. You know, you're not going to do it twice. If that happened and you get lucky, you're never going to touch it again. So it's just something kind of scary about the bulbs. It can happen, I guess. I just washed the car, really stoked. It's been a long time since I washed it, even though it might rain pretty soon. But it is looking good. I need to dry the exhaust and the wheels next. Black paint is looking really good. I just gotta dry it, but I mean, look at that. It's killer. Almost had one guy, local guy, ready to buy these sweet black painted mufflers. But he kind of thought they had a different sound too with these baffles. I said there's really not too much different sound. You're mostly buying these for looks, and I mean they're not 100% flawless, but they're good. There isn't any big scratches or anything. They're decent. So and I had someone thinking about that shorty resonator, the short one there. I'm gonna put this one back on. I was just about to tell you about that. I ran my straight WRX midpipe for a few days since Thursday, Friday. Got a little tone going. And as usual, I am getting a little tired of it now. It just comes in phases. I did buy all new bolts for my both sides, the front of the midpipe and the muffler side. I bought all kinds of these this kind of stuff and got just the right lengths for the M10 125 30s. And a 25 mil long was perfect for the mufflers, so you didn't have tons of excess bolt in the back there. And I got a little bit longer ones for the center. The cob springs do not fit with the cob adapter. I mean, you gotta like channel lock those tight, and it just strips it out. It's just not a good deal. So I just got really nice, easy to use zinc plated bolts for the middle two. So it's really, it just comes off like butter every time I do it. It isn't like I'm putting wear on the car every time I change the mid pipe. So I think today the project is I'm going to take off the WRX mid pipe, put the STI mid pipe back on, go quiet again for a while. Aside from that, this is my Neelite Fogs I've had ready to ship for a while. I have a local guy that's meaning to come by to take both the color light bar and the fogs, but three times we've tried to hook up. He probably has kids too. We just can't get synced up to be home at the right time so he can come take these off my hands. Aside from that, I'm not sure what I'm gonna do with these bulbs now. Now these are the customized trays that have the polarity reversed. Since they're like almost, I mean, they work 100%, but since they're just, you know, play bulbs, I got them free. So, you know, you can't complain to the manufacturer. I got them free. So I may even cut these deeper and try and do like a really nice job on them, a nicer job, really clean them up. Just because, I mean, I have nothing to lose at this point, and they're out of the Forester. All bulbs are out of the Forester, as I said. It's 100% stock. And then, of course, I have the NS03 that came out of the Forester before I put these in. Still have all the tints intact. I'd probably sell these, but now I'm kind of thinking I might need to save them for a rainy day, because you never know, you know, what kind of bulbs I might need. And I like this set a lot. It's just not as strong as I would like, but it is a nice set. And you could even make this set the 6500 temperature with the tint there, but it's just not going to have that quite brightness as the trays do, which are really beautiful. The LED is really good right now, the LED bar. This is aimed a little bit higher than the last install. After I tried those fogs, remember? Then I put this back in, I tilted it a tiny bit higher, and I think it does get a better frontal lighting now, even at night I can tell. Before it was aimed a little bit toward the ground, so you weren't quite seeing a really good effect. No difference in temperature so far. No reason to take it out. I'll use it next time I'm up in the dark, and we'll see if it looks even better than before. Aside from that, although I was tempted to rip out all the LEDs from this car just because I just had the panic, like this electronic stuff is just gonna blow, man. It's all solid, it all works, so I'm just not gonna touch it, I guess, but just something to be aware of. I guess that's it for now.